I understand that it would be a terrible exaggeration to say the world has not changed, but we are in the middle of a major thing on race in this country, not just race in policing, not just race in incarceration. For all the progress we've made in the year that is the 50th anniversary of the Voting Rights Act, there is still an extraordinary amount that we don't have resolved.
But you have to understand, people are trying to resolve something that's never going to be resolved because it's a
really
part, it's the ugly
that's
part.
That's the spoiler.
No, it's not. It's not a spoiler.
Yeah,
there's an ugly part of human nature. You know, if every I remember that Star Trek episode. I really don't live my life by the declarations of what pop art. But remember, one guy was black on one side of his face and white on the other side, and he was fighting this other guy who looked just like him.
Yeah.
And then at the end of the episode, you realize, and everyone said, why are you guys fighting? He goes, what are you talking about? I'm black on the right side. He's black on the left side. And we're like, what? People will find a distinction to have issues with. I personally believe because it's a part. Sorry, sound.
No, it's okay.
I personally believe because that's an ugly part of human nature. Yeah. What happens every once in a while is the veil is lifted and we see it even more clearly. It has to be an awakening and an epiphany for people when they see it for the first time, you know? And what happens in the journey of life is we're always trying to evolve to get better. That's why we go and have these moments of trying to understand the human spirit. That's what art is about, where we reflect on who we are, where we've been. So the issues that we're having with race now is understanding that this amorphic dysfunction in our human spirit is something that we always have to be vigilant about to catch, make it a teachable moment for people understanding it for the first time or seeing it for the first time, and changing the game when it comes to attacking it.
Yep.
Like right now, there are people saying, the most important voices in American discussion of racial politics right now are the folks who are saying, oh, these black guys are not making it up. I saw it on film for the first time. Right. Oh, I see. Actually, we had an incident just last week where it happened to a white kid in Michigan, which I think is gonna be even more evident of what those who disgrace the badge, very important, disgrace the badge, do in moments of conflict. You know, I personally believe that that young man didn't have to die because he was being so disruptive.
Easy to dismiss it when it's happening to somebody who you don't recognize.
And then all of a sudden, I recognize that kid because he looks like my son. He's, you know, this blonde-haired, blue-eyed kid that, you know, maybe they were overreaching, maybe they were being exaggerated. So it's a constant vigilance that we have to have.